Hello, welcome again to my YouTube channel. So for today's video, I'm going to share with you how I organize my schedules using Notion. So Notion is a platform that makes it very easy for you to organize your schedule. I was really surprised. It's been about 2 weeks since I started using this platform, and so far I'm enjoying it. So Notion is kind of like your Excel, like your Microsoft Excel, or your it's everything in itself. It's like your diary, it has everything. So let me take you through Notion, and I'll also take you through using Notion to plan a book club. So you have books that you like to read, and also plan how to read those books. So I will make it very simple, because the platform itself, it's a little bit it has a steep learning curve. So if you have someone to give you the guidelines on how to create it very easily, it would fasten your studying process. So let's go without much words and see how to make a book club using Notion. Okay, so welcome to the page. So you can see over here that I just opened a Google. So to start with that, let's go to Notion, right? And with Notion, you can just start with this blank page. Well, this is my page, so I already have the setup. But if it's for you, what you might see is that you might see an empty page, right? And you have to create your own account. So you can create a simple account, and it's free. You have to choose personal. For personal, it's free, and then for groups, you have to pay a little bit of some money, or there'll be some restrictions on how far you can use it. Yeah, but for personal use, it's very free, right? So what I would like to do is that let me show you my platform. So with this platform, I have planned everything up here. So I have movies, I have what I do when I'm bored, I have my travel sections, my daily plans, my yearly goals, and some other things. This is just something, my trading journal, my projects, health, finance, web development, because I'm a web developer. And then my YouTube. So before I make the YouTube video, I also have to plan and then write the scripts, right? And I also have a book club. This is what I would like to show you, and this is just something else. Okay, so let's start with a book club. So this is a book club that I have, and I will just take you through the simple book club that I've made here. Well, it's easy to make this board, but for a beginner, it's quite a Herculean task. So let's see how this thing works. What I do is that first I write recommendations. So if a friend recommends a book to me, what I do is that I come here and then I add it to it. So I add a book and then I add a title to everything. And then what happens is that, let me take you here. So I don't need this. Let me delete this. Delete. Okay. So when I have the books here, the recommended books, if I go ahead to buy those books, right, then I'll move that book to my collection. It means that I've bought it, right? So it's part of my collection. So you see, it leaves the recommended section to my collection, right? And I have two different collections. So the hard collection and then the soft collection. If I'm able to download a book from the internet, like using a website, like those websites, PDF section, then I can just move those books to the PDF section because I already have it downloaded, right? I really don't like PDF books. I prefer hard copy. So I usually like to have my collections, and I have a small library here. Okay, so after your collections, then it has to now move to reading. So when I start reading, so if for now I'm reading about 3 books, are you smart enough to work at Google? 7 habits of highly effective, highly efficient people. Oh my god, I spelled this wrong. Well, so 7 habits of highly efficient. Why do I say efficient when it's effective? So effective people. Well, I can easily correct this on its page. So effective people. And then that is it. So it's corrected. Right? 7 habits of highly effective people. And then the last one is 7 reasons why. Actually, this is a net, it's a so actually, this is a Netflix series, right? Which is also in the book form. So after I'm done reading, then I move it to read, right? So this is how I keep a chronology of all the books I'm reading, the books I'm about to read, and then the collection, so I don't forget them, right? because I usually forget things. All right, so let's create this book clubs. It's very easy, so let's start. So first I'm going to create a page. So let's create new and then call it YouTube book club, right? So this is the title, and after creating the title you can then add an icon. There's an icon of a, it like looks like a shirt. I really don't like such icons, so let's use an icon of a book, right? So you could use this. I would like to use the one, this just a similar one I created. So this is a stack of books, right? And then you can add a cover, so it automatically generates a cover. But if you don't like this cover, you can also use your own cover. Let me change the cover. And the good thing is that you have the option to use on splash. Here it's good for designers. You're able to pick pictures for free, blah blah blah. So what I'll do is that I'll search for books. So this is where I got my books from. Like you can see I got mine here, but you could also use this, you could also use that. Let me see, bookshelf. You see bookshelf, there is a plethora of options here. You can try some of the options, right? You see it comes so neat, right? So I like to use this one, and then perhaps change the color of this to just something single. I like simple things. I don't like, wow, that's all, so simple. So you have your book club, right? Your cover, your icon, right? Now it comes to the content of the page. So for the content of the page, what I would advise is that for any page you like to create, just use a database. So how do you do that? So you just go to, you use the slash here and then search for database. Well, if you don't want to search, you can just type database, and in the database section you have inline database, full page database. Use the first one, the inline database section. So when you click on inline database, it gives you the option, right? So this is a table. It's hard for some people to understand this one, but it's understandable. So you have two sections here, right? Two columns, right? So you can name it here as book club, and then in the first column, what would you like to be there? Well, I would like to see the title, right? The title of the book. So you click edit and then you write title. You like this to be the title, right? Let me make it capital. Yes, title is good here. And then the type. So if it's a title, what type should it be? Should it be text or it should be something else? Well, it's a title, so I just leave it a type as title, right? That makes sense, right? Okay, now let's go to the next part, the next column. So the next column says tags, but you don't really need tags. You can even delete all these things. You can delete. So where is the delete section? Delete property. Yes, delete it, right? Because I want to add mine. In fact, you could even delete the title here, but the title is okay for us. So let's continue with this. So you see, let's continue with this one. I want to now add my own property. So if you have a book club, you need a title of the books and also you need the author. So the author of the book, so you just write author, and then it should be a text, right? Well, you see there are properties here. You could use a number, a selection, multi, satellite, so many of them, right? But I would like to just use the text, right? So we use a text because you're going to write it in text. Okay, good. And then the next column for our table should be the status, right? So we just call it status. And with status, what we like to do is that we want it to have options, like to have heading. So where you have red recommendations, like I showed you in the beginning. So for that property, you have to choose the select button, right? You could choose status, right? But the status is what they've already designed it for you, but I don't really like that one. I like to make my own options, right? So I just do select, and the select comes with options, right? So select options. What kind of options would you like to see? Like to see recommendation, right? So recommended books, right? Well, let me just recommendations. It's okay. I'm trying to bring in variety here, but it looks like it's not working. Alright, so recommendations, with books you have recommendations. And then you could also have reading, right? So books you are reading. And then you could also have soft copy. So the soft copy books you are reading. You could also have the hard copy books you are reading. Hard copy books you are reading. Right? And then you could also have done reading. So books you are done reading with, right? So these are part of the options, and options is part of the select type, right? Okay. I hope you're going along with me. This is very easy. Alright, so we are done with the property. So we have the title, we have the author, we have the status. What else should we add to this? Let's add something like a date. So the date could be the date that you actually added this book to your section. So the date that you actually added the books to your book club. So let's look for that one as date added, right? And then date should definitely be under date. It shouldn't be something else. Date is date, right? So you could just choose date. So what do we have here? We have four columns, right, in our database, but at the moment we have no data, right? So we can create a simple data here. So in a book, you know, let me use, I already have some books I'd like to add here. So Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman. Yes. And then the status should be maybe recommended. And then I will just add a date. So let's say, let me just put random dates. So there's a date added. Let me put about five of them. So you can speed up the video whilst I add the other details. Okay, so let's go with this one. Okay, so back to this page, you can see that I have about five books, right? I've written five books with the authors, right? And on the status, I would like to choose at least this is done reading, this is hard copy, this is soft copy, and then this is reading, right? Our five options, right? After you are done with the database, and then the date. So let me just choose randomly any date for this ones. Okay. Okay, and then that. So these are the dates that the books were added, right? Okay, now you have your database. Now if you have your database, you can now use this database to create different types of views. So on this side, you can just click here, and then it gives you the options to create views. So there's a table view which you have here, there's a board, there's a timeline, there's a gallery section, there's a list, there's a calendar. So but where we like to go is the board. So we click on board, and then you see it says new view. So with a new view, you can decide to rename it, right? It's a board view, but you can decide to rename it. And under it, you can see that I have all my books here, right? Let me make the setup. So you can also set the length and width of your page. So let me make it full width, so you can see with the full width of my page, right, I have my done reading here, but I would like to arrange them. So I like the recommended to be first, soft copy to be second, soft copy to be second, my hard copy third, reading fourth, then done reading should be last, right? All right, so in the beginning, you can assume that they are all recommended books, right? So you see how easy it is to just move things around. You see, I've been able to move everything around, right? And maybe this one is a soft copy I have, I just put it here. And that is a hard copy I have, I just put it here. And then the rest, I just arrange the rest. And let's say I start reading, right? So maybe I start reading this book and then that book, I just put them here, right? And as time goes on, if I'm done reading, I just put it here. Then I keep on with the rest. So by the end of the year, I would know the number of books I've read, and also know when I read them, right? And also, you can also change it into a calendar. So let's say you could have a calendar view. So you just select calendar view, and then you're done. So you see, when you have a calendar view, look at the options that it gives you. So what does it tell you? It tells you that the day I added a book, right? So think reading fast. Thinking fast and slow. I added it here on the 10th of July. And then the other books. See? So you can also move them around if maybe you want to change the date. You don't have to manually do everything. So far as you have a database, it's easy for you to just change everything around. Or maybe you want to read it at a particular time, right? So maybe I want to start reading Thinking Fast and Slow from this time, and I want to read Awakening the Giant Within You at this time. So just move it around, and then when I'm done, I want to read this. So you can do this for the whole year. You can just do this for the whole year, and you can also set a notification so that when it is time, you are elected on which books to read. Okay, so that's how to create a simple book club, and I hope that you are able to also follow along and also do this. Please share with me how you're able to also do your book club. And if you like my video and you also like me to make videos on other subjects, you can also recommend in the comment section. And I'm so happy that you're able to watch to the end. Please like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.